Hi guys, good evening to all. Sorry, good morning to all. So welcome to CFR classes. This is CS Sai Kumar. So before watching this video, please like, share and subscribe. Okay. So actually this video is a MCQ question from set 1 problems. Set 1 as well as a set 2 model papers. Clear? So see question number 1. Simple sir. This question is from Ind AS 34 actually. But this stand is not there for new syllabus students. So, but even though institute had given this question in September 1 model paper. So it's a simple question, sir, actually. So please read once. Simple, sir. Company showed a net profit of 7,20,000 for third quarter. Okay. For the year 2018-19 after incorporating the following. So after incorporating all the adjustments, after adjusting all the below adjustments. Okay. So net profit is 7,20,000. Okay. So read first number, point number 1. Bad debts of 40,000 incurred during the quarter. 50% of bad debts have been deferred to the next year. So next quarter. Simple sir. As per Ind AS 34. Ind AS 34. If any expense incurred or if any income earned, we must recognize in particular quarter only, not to defer any other quarter. If you deferred any expense or any income, we have to adjust it. We have to adjust in that particular quarter. Here, particular quarter is nothing but third quarter. Clear? See, bad debts of 40,000 total bad debts how much? 40,000. Clear? So 50% have been deferred to next quarter. Nothing but 20,000 have been deferred to next quarter. If the expense is reduced, if you recognize less expense, then profit will show us more. Obviously, profit will show us more. Correct? So, actually, we have to recognize 40,000 expense in quarter 3. But we recognize 20,000 only in quarter 3. So, that's why. Just wait a moment. Okay. Sorry, ma. So, actually, we have to recognize 40,000 in quarter 3. But we recognize only 20,000 only. If the expense is recognized less, then profit will show us more. So this is mistake now. So we have to correct it. 50% balance defer to next quarter. That's why profit will show us more. So we have to reduce that particular amount from profit. How much, sir? 20,000. So 7,20,000 minus 20,000. This 20,000 is bad debt, sir. Okay, this 20,000 differ to next quarter, sir, actually. So that's why we have to reduce from net profit. Next, extraordinary loss of 35,000 incurred during the quarter have been fully recognized in the quarter. Obviously, no issue. So fully recognized in particular quarter only. So no issue. There's no adjustment required. So how much, sir? 7 lakhs. That is option number B. Simple question. Simple question. Clear? Next question number 2. In conglomerate merger of 2 companies into a new company. So simple sir. Mergers are 2 types. So conglomerate and concentric. Correct? Okay now. So conglomerate means concentric means similar industries. Conglomerate means different industries. Nothing but unrelated. So unrelated. So option number B. Simple. Unrelated markets having no functional economic relationship. Here, we already discussed in marathon class. Next, point number 3. So, details of an asset. Cost of asset is 60 lakhs. Useful life for 10 years. Salvage value 4 lakhs. Here, useful life remaining years is 3 years. Upward valuation done in last year by 50%. Current value is uses 12 lakhs. Current selling price is 11 lakhs. Current disposal cost is 1 lakh. Impairment loss to charge to P&L as per applicable index would be how much? Applicable index 36. Okay. Clear? Simple question, sir. Actually, cost of asset is 60 lakhs. Clear? Useful life 10 years, salvage value 4 lakhs. So, please calculate the depreciation. Simple, sir. 60 minus 4 lakhs divided by 10. Okay. How much, sir? 56 by 10. 5.6 lakhs. This is the depreciation per 1 year. Nothing but per annum. Clear? See, sir. Simple. Actually, 5.6 lakhs per annum. That is the depreciation. Okay, clear. But useful life remaining 3 years. Upward revaluation done in last year by 50%. So nothing but this upward revaluation done in 6th year or 7th year. Sorry, 8th year or 7th year means nothing but 7th year, sir. 7th year upward revaluation has been done. 50%. So first of all, we have to calculate depreciation for 6 years. So 5.6 into 6, how much, sir? So please take your calculator. 5.6 into 6, how much, sir? 33.6 is the depreciation. Cost of asset is 60. So 60 minus 33.6. 60 minus 33.6, how much, sir? 26.4. This is the book value at the beginning of a 7th year. Nothing but 7th year beginning, the book value is 26.4. In 7th year, upward revaluation done by 50%. So we have to add 50% on it. So 26.4 plus 50%. Please take the calci and then calculate. Plus 26.4 plus 50%. How much, sir? 39.6. This is the carrying value as on 7th year beginning. So now we are going to calculate depreciation for 7th year. Please, sir, please calculate. 39.6 is the carrying value. Okay, 39.6 is the carrying value. So next salvage value is 4 lakhs. So 39.6 minus 4 by total, how many years are remaining? 4 years, including 7th year. So, till now we did not calculate any, we did not deduct any depreciation for 7th year. Just we depreciated, sorry, we calculated only for 6 years only. So, 7th year depreciation, so remaining useful life is 4 years, nothing but 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 39.6 minus 4 by 4, how much, sir? 8.9. So, this is the 7th year depreciation. So depreciate, nothing but reduce the value from book value of asset. How much, sir? 39.6 minus 8.9. 39.6 minus 8.9. How much, sir? 30.7. This is the book value as on 7th year ending. Nothing but 7th year ending book value is how much, sir? 30.7. Clear? This point clear, sir? Okay, so 30.7 is the book value. Next, simple, sir. Actually, question was asking about impairment loss. So impairment loss means we have to calculate carrying amount as well as a recoverable value. Nothing but recoverable amount. How we will get recoverable amount, sir? Simple, value in use or fair value less cost to sell, whichever is higher. So in the question, value is already given, sir. How much, sir? Current value is 12 lakhs. 12 lakhs. Okay, 12. Next, fair value less cost to sell. Fair value is also given, sir. So please check that. So current selling price is nothing but fair value. How much, sir? 11 lakhs minus cost of a disposal, nothing but a cost to sale. How much, sir? 1 lakh. So 11 minus 1, 10 lakhs. Whichever is higher, 12 lakhs. So recoverable amount is 12. Carrying amount, how much, sir? Carrying amount 30.7. So 30.7 is the carrying amount, 12 is the recoverable amount. How much, sir? 18.7 is the impairment loss. Option number K. Is that clear? Simple question. Next, which are the not a feature of government accounting? Simple, sir. It's not a feature of reporting utilization of public funds, obviously correct. Double entry system, obviously correct. It's a fund-based accounting, not a non-fund-based accounting. So it's a wrong, sir. Actually, it is a fund-based accounting. So option C. Next, C Limited acquired 60% acquired on January 1st. C Limited paid 700 lakhs in cash for their interest. Fair value of G Limited assets is 1800 and fair value of liabilities is 900. So NCA. Simple, sir. NCA means, sir, net assets into percentage of NCA. If a question says nothing, we will calculate NC on the base of a proportionate net assets method. Simple, sir. 1800 minus 900. So 900 lakhs into how much, sir? 40%. Nothing but 316 lakhs. Option A. Bacha question. Next, sir. What will the gain or loss booked in the financial year 2021, 2022? Simple, sir. The difference between these two values. So 78.6 purchased goods on 12/3/2022, but the exchange rate on year ending is 79. So exchange rate value increase nothing but is a loss to the entity. So how much sir loss? 78.6 minus 79. How much sir? 78.6 minus 79. 0.4. So 0.4 into 1 lakh. How much sir? 40,000 loss. Option B. Simple. Next, which of the following is a financial asset to buy? Financial asset is nothing but say cash. Next, contractual right to deliver a cash and a equity instrument of another entity. Okay, equity instrument of another entity is also known as financial asset. So A, B, C, all of the above. Next, which of the following rate is not used in the not used, sir? Not used means in the context of ESG. Nothing but environmental test criterion all is there. Next, social test criterion and governance test criterion. These 3 points already covered in ESG. So competitive test criterion is not there. So option D is the answer. Not used, sir. Next, point number 9. Index 109. Accounting and reporting for business combination is done under acquisition method, sir. Acquisition method I already told in marathon video also. Last question. Simple question, sir. Sir, this question actually today CFR, nothing but yesterday exam. Old silver students, sir. They got this question for 2 marks. Simple question, sir. Actually, how much percentage of amount we have to transfer to incurred on CSR activities, nothing but 2% of last 3 years average net profit, nothing but. So please check, sir. Last 3 years profits almost 25, 20, 15, nothing but. Clear, sir? 25, 20, 15 and 10, 5. These are the 5 years net profits. 5 years net profits. Okay, clear, sir? So, present we are in 2020, 2021. Okay, so nothing but this is the first year. Last 3 years means 19, 20, 18, 19, 17, 18. Nothing but 20, 15, 10. Clear. 20 plus 15 plus 10 by 3. How much, sir? 35, 45 by 3. Nothing but 15. 15 into 2%. How much, sir? 15 into 2%. 15 crores into 2%. Nothing but 30 lakhs. 15 crores into 2% is 30 lakhs, sir. We have to incur expenditure on CSR activities, but the company incurred 7 lakhs only and 3 lakhs on a company incurred 7 lakhs and 3 lakhs on free education and medical treatment for employees of the company and their families respectively under CSR projects. How much, sir? So calculate the shortfall of expenditure on CSR responsibility as per the company set. Simple, sir. Actually, in case of a CSR activities, we cannot consider the medical treatment for employees. If the free education is covered under CSR activity, but the medical treatment of employees is not covered under CSR activity. So, expenditure incurred is only 7 lakhs only. Total, they have to incur 30 lakhs. So, shortfall is how much, sir? 23 lakhs. This is a simple question, but now many of the students don't know about this employees point. Okay, now? Clear, sir? Simple. This is the set number 1 MCQs. Next, sir, set number 2. Question number 1, sir. Simple question. JLMP purchased a plan for $50,000 on 31st October 2020, payable after 6 months. Okay. The company entered into a forward contract of 6 months at the rate of 64.5 per dollar, but on 31st 2020, exchange rate was $61.5 per dollar. The profit and loss for the contract year 31st March 2021. Nothing but simple, sir. Contract entered on 31st October 2020. But they're asking profit or loss on the future contract, nothing but forward contract for the year ended 31st March 2021. Nothing but actually the contract For 6 months, actual contract period is 6 months, but from 31st October, I think about November to March, how many months are November, December, January, February, March? I think about 5 months. So we have to allocate the total loss for 5 months only because we are recognizing in 31st March. Actually, the period will end on 30th April actually, but they are asking. Question was asking profit and loss for 31st March only. So the difference between the two exchange rates, you have to calculate difference between the two exchange rates for 5 months only. Nothing but 60 contract ended for 64.25, but exchange rate is 61.5. How much is the difference? 64.5, sorry, 64.25 minus 61.5, how much sir? 2.75, clear? So 2.75 into how many dollars are $50,000 into $50,000 to $50,000? How much sir? 1,37,500 is the answer. No sir, it's a wrong answer because we have to calculate for 5 months only. Simple 5 by 6, total 6 months are, so that's why we have to calculate for 5 by 6, sir, 5 months only, so that's why 5 by 6. How much, sir? 1,14,583. Option B. Option B, sir. Simple. Simple question, sir. Next, this is a calculation of average profit. Simple. We have to calculate a capitalizer value of a profit. Nothing but a capitalizer profit. How will we get, sir? How we will get that? Simple, sir. Profit before tax. Question is given. Profit before tax. So we have to reduce the tax from particular profit. So 1 lakh minus 28%. How much, sir? 72,000 is the profit. So we have to calculate a capital, nothing but net assets. Actual capital, but capitalized profit. How we will get capitalized profits are simple. 72,000 by NRR. NRR how much, sir? 12%. So 72,000 divided by 12%. How much, sir? 6 lakhs. Simple 6 lakhs. Actually, we don't have that much time. That's why I'm discussing very quickly, nothing but very fastly. Okay, now there is no need to keep your video on 1.5 speed. So, almost my speed will 1.5 only. So, clear? So, total how much, sir? 6 lakhs. So, this is the capitalized profit minus capital, how much, sir? 4 lakh 80. Simple, sir. So, 6 lakhs minus 4 lakh 80. How much, sir? 1,20,000. Option A. Simple question. Actually, this is the question from Institute material only. Next, Car Limited observe Bar Limited and shares by Car Limited using swap ratio 3:7. Nothing but for 7 shares, Car Limited will issue 3 shares only. Actually, how many shares in Car Limited? Nothing but sorry, Bar Limited, not Car, Bar Limited. Actually, Car Limited will issue 3 shares for 7 shares in Bar Limited. Total, how many shares in Bar Limited means nothing but 70,000. So 70,000 shares total. So Car Limited will give 3 shares for 7 shares, nothing but 3 by 7. How many, sir? How much, sir? 30,000 shares will give by Car Limited. 30 shares will issue by Car Limited. So 30,000 into fair value. How much, sir? Fair value 14 rupees of Car Limited only. Car Limited only because shares are issuing by Car Limited now. So we have to take fair value of Car Limited only. How much, sir? 4.2 lakhs. Next point number 4, same bachcha question from sit one question. Next point number 5, simple sir. Question was asking about gain on bargain purchase. Simple sir, do you know about simple formula PC plus NCI minus net assets? PC means how much sir? 80% investment of B Limited for 560 lakhs. So 560 plus NCI how much sir? So identifiable net assets is 960, liability is 160. How much, sir? Net assets 960 minus 160, 800. 960 minus 160, 800. So 800 into 20%. How much, sir? 160. This is NCA. 800 into 20%. 160. Clear? This is NCA minus net assets. How much, sir? 800. So please calculate. 560 plus 160 minus 800. How much, sir? 80 lakhs. Sorry, sir. Question was asking about NCI is measured at fair value. So we have to calculate NCI as per fair value only. So clear, sir. So please read the question properly. Okay, na? So NCI have to calculate as per fair value. How you will get NCI as per fair value? Simple, sir. 560 lakhs for 80%. We want 20%. How much, sir? 560 by 80 into 20, 140. Clear. So 140 is the NCA. So now calculate 560 plus 140 minus 800. How much, sir? 100. 100 negative, positive, negative. So that is known as gain on bargain purchase. If the difference is positive, goodwill, it is known as goodwill. If the difference is negative, it is known as gain on bargain purchase. 100 lakhs, option B. Please read the question properly. NCA calculate as per fair value. If the question is not mentioned anything, so we have to calculate NCA as per proportionate net assets method only. Simple. GAZAP stands for Government Accounting Standards Advisory Board. Okay. Next, external benefits of a sustainable reporting can include dash and why. Simple, sir. Please read all the questions. Actually, they are asking external benefits. Actually, two types of benefits: internal benefits, external benefits. Okay, improve reputation and brand loyalty is an external benefit, obviously. Enhance the perception and organization value is also, and sir, nothing but it is also external benefit. So, question is asking about actually. Okay, next, mitigating or reversing a negative environmental, social, and government impacts. So it is also, we can say that external benefit only. So all of the above symbol. So this point we can add in sustainable reporting question. Next, the Ind AS 133 states that acquirer obtains a control over acquiring, recognize and measures its consolidated financial statements at the acquisition date. Justify your answer. Simple. Identify assets acquired, liabilities at fair value. Any NCA in the acquiry at fair value or at a proportionate value. The goodwill acquired in the business combination or a gain on bargain purchase, all of the above. Chapman, sir, simple, sir. All of the above. Obviously, sir, net assets will take at fair value. NCA can be measured at fair value or in a proportionate net assets method. Next, goodwill or gain on bargain purchase in case of a combination. Correct? So, all of the above. Clear? Next, last question, sir. Ninth question. As Ind AS 133 accounting and reporting for business combination, the common control is done under dash methods are simple polling interest method. So we already know that point. Next, dash is any contract that evidences residual interest. Residual interest means remaining interest. Okay, so who will get remaining interest is nothing but equity instruments. Nothing but equity, sir. So equity instrument is any contract that evidences a residual interest in the assets of an entity after deducting all of its liabilities. If there is pending, it will take by the equity instruments. Nothing but residual interest. Last. Clear, sir. This is both. This is MCQ question from both set 1 and set 2. So please watch this video. Simple, sir. How much time is nothing but obviously just 20 minutes. So in case of if you keep it the video at a 1.5 speed, you will complete this video in 10 to 15 minutes. Simple, sir. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.